गुड मॉर्निंग 7th क्लास स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी आर मेकिंग द रिविजन ऑफ चैप्टर फर्स्ट एंड चैप्टर टू विद द वीडियो ऑनलाइन क्लासेस. एंड इन दिस रिविजन क्लास वी आर स्टडिंग अबाउट द वेरी शॉर्ट टाइप क्वेश्चंस, शॉर्ट आंसर टाइप क्वेश्चंस एंड लॉन्ग आंसर टाइप क्वेश्चंस. सो आई होप यू विल नॉट फील एनी डिफिकल्टीज टू अंडरस्टैंड मल्टीपल चॉइस क्वेश्चंस. फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स, match the column and true false. So we should start with very short answer type questions. What are the two components of lichen, that is alga and fungus? Okay, list the condition necessary for photosynthesis. It means what are the main conditions which would be required for performing the photosynthesis process. So that is chlorophyll, sunlight, carbon dioxide and water. So these four conditions are necessary for photosynthesis. Name two insectivorous plants. So that is pitcher plant and Venus flytrap. So these two name of the plants of insectivorous. What do you understand by the term host? So for the host, what do you understand by the term host? So it means define host. So parasites are those organisms, plants and animals, which obtain food from the other organisms called host. So parasites are those organisms. So it means the host is the organisms by which parasites can get their food. It means host generally the parasites are depend for foods. Okay, and parasites may be plants and animals. Write the chemical equation for photosynthesis. So on page number A2, so we have to open page number A2. So these are the condition necessary for photosynthesis. Photosynthesis can be written in the form of a chemical equation, that is carbon dioxide plus water in the presence of chlorophyll and sunlight, formation of glucose and oxygen as a product. Okay, so when it means carbon dioxide they can get from atmosphere, water from the roots, from the ground, chlorophyll already contained in their green leaves, and sunlight and glucose and oxygen. Okay, so these are the very short questions. And sixth one is, which chemical used to find the occurrence the photosynthesis, that is the iodine solution. Define the term autograph. Okay, so what do you mean by autograph? Autotroph. Generally, the autotrophic mode of nutrition can be done. And on page number A6, so what is autotroph? An organism synthesizing their own food. It means those organisms which can synthesize their own food, that is known as autotrophs. Now, short answer type question on page number, why do pickles spoil in rainy season? So, fungal spores are present in air in rainy season. They germinate and grow on leather items. It means fungal spores generally present in air, and in rainy season, they generally germinate and grow on leather items and pickles and spoils them. It means generally on leather items and pickles, that's why they are just spoiling. And these fungal spores generally produce and production and multiplication in generally in rainy seasons. That's why they germinate and grow. Now, short two, how does parasites plants get their food? So on page number A4, how does parasitic plant has special tubular structures called haustoria that penetrates into the tissue of the tree from which it gets food. It means haustoria just penetrate into the tissue of the tree and they can get from the food. So it is a tubular like structure in the parasites, and they just take and engulf the food from particular host, maybe the plants or animals. So now what is stomata? How does it help in photosynthesis? The small pores present on the lower surface of leaf called stomata. Okay, so small pores generally present on lower surface of leaf called known as stomata. It absorb CO2 from air for photosynthesis. Means it can absorb carbon dioxide from air for photosynthesis, and stomata facilitates exchange of gases and water. So generally stomata are used or may be function as a exchange of gases and water. It means to outside or to inside. Now our first long questions, differentiate between parasites and saprophytes. So on page number A4, okay, on page number A4. So long first is starting from here. Parasites are those organisms, it means maybe plants, animals, which obtain food from the organisms called host. And it is a kind of association in which only parasites are benefited, because only parasites are getting food. There is a no advantage of the host in this case. Okay, so parasitic nature here it is benefited. Now two, three examples we can see. So most of examples of these parasite plants are mistletoe, rafflesia, yellow rattle, witchweed and broom rape are some other parasitic plants. Okay, so parasitic plants are those animals, maybe plants or animals which obtain from the host, food from the host. It means they are just depending, and in this case there is no benefits getting by the host through this parasitic nature. Okay, now the differentiate between parasites and saprophytes. So saprophytes, we already discussed this parasites. Now the saprophytes is the mode of nutrition in which organisms takes nutrients from dead and decaying matter is called saprophytic nature. It means in the mode of nutrition in which organisms, maybe plants or animals, get food from dead and decaying matter. And we already discussed in our online classes also these saprophytic plants. Plants that use saprophytic mode of nutrition are called saprophytes. It means those are behaving or maybe involving with the saprophytic mode. They are known as saprophytes. Like examples, saprophytes are fungi, mushrooms, Indian orchid, snow orchid, etc. And all saprophytes lack chlorophyll. It means they are not having the proper chlorophyll. And that's why, and these are the examples for fungi, mushrooms, Indian orchid and snow orchids. Okay, it means generally they are saprophytes is a those are behaving like a saprophytic mode of nutrition. So this is the our long first. Now long second, what do you understand by the term nutrition? Name two major types of mode of nutrition in plants. So define nutrition, it means, and two major types of mode of nutrition we also see. So first we have to see the definitions. The process of obtaining and utilizing food by organisms is known as nutrition. The process of obtaining and utilizing food by organisms is nutrition, and nutrition is of two types, autotrophic nutrition and heterotrophic nutrition. So what do you understand by the autotrophic? You know, means auto means self, troph means to synthesis. It means those can synthesis with the self. It means the mode of nutrition in which a living organism can make its own food is called autotrophic nutrition. And most heterotrophic, most of the organisms and animals depend on the plants or other animals for their food. This is known as heterotrophic. Hetero means others, and tropic means to nourishment or to synthesis. It means those can prepare their self food is known as autotrophs, and those can be depend on others for food matters, maybe plants or other animals, that is known as heterotrophs or heterotrophic nutritions. Okay, this is our first law. Okay, and now the second law, and third law. How can you show that chlorophyll is essential for photosynthesis? So on page number A3. Okay, this activity we already discussed in our online classes also. So here we are describing as a long three answer. To show that chlorophyll necessary for photosynthesis, first we put the coleus or croton leaves in boiling water for 2 minutes. Take out the leaf from the water and keep it in a test tube containing alcohol. Okay, croton or coleus leaf means they are the variegated leaves. It means in there some colors are just different from the green color. It means they are having a different one more color which is not in green color. So we have to keep this in boiling water for 2 minutes. After that we have to take this leaf from the water and to keep a test tube containing alcohol. Okay, we are just first in boiling water we have to keep, and then we have to keep into the beaker which is having the containing water with alcohol. Okay, test tube containing alcohol. In this test tube we are having the alcohol, and here it is a boiling. We are not directly heating this test tube with alcohol to flame, that's why we have to heat this alcohol with leaf, then we have to boil this water and till the leaf losses. Okay, so heat the test tube till the leaf losses the whole green color. Take out the leaf and wash it with fresh water. Okay, we have to take now this leaf and wash it with the fresh water. Put it on a watch glass and add a few drops. Okay, now we have to wash. Okay, and put it on a watch glass. This is the watch glass. Okay, and now a few drops of iodine solution we are keeping on that. Okay, so iodine solution gives blue black color with the starch. Generally, iodine solution gives the blue black color with the starch. Green portion of leaf turns blue black. Okay, so you know this is the croton leaf, and the green portion containing will turn blue black, whereas non-green portion remains brown with iodine solution. So where there is a no green part, that will be remains brown with the iodine solution. So hence chlorophyll is essential for photosynthesis. It means that's why the chlorophyll is essential for photosynthesis. Okay, because only green portion contain the chlorophyll, and chlorophyll, due to the chlorophyll, this blue black color will be shown. Okay, because iodine solution is just give the blue black color with the starch. Okay, so I hope you understood this. This is our first chapter, question answers revision, and now we are starting our second chapter, that name is nutrition in animals. Okay, this is the nutrition in animals. Very easy chapter for you, because we already discussed many things from this chapter, and I hope you will try to understand this MCQ, fill in the blanks. Okay, match the column at true false. We are starting with the short answer type questions, only one word, like which is the largest part of alimentary canal, that is small intestine. Give two example of ruminants, cow and buffalo. List the five steps of nutrition: ingestion, digestion, absorption, assimilation and egestion. Okay, we already discussed in our classes. Which mouth part does help in sucking of liquid food in butterflies, that is proboscis. Okay, name two animals have sticky tongue, that is lizard and frog. Okay, which food processing structure is present in hydra, that is tentacle. And then in which animal does intracellular digestion takes place, that is amoeba. What are the four type of teeth present in human, that is incisors, canines, premolars and molars. Okay, which enzyme is secreted by salivary glands, that is amylase. Okay, maybe sometime we have to tell tylin also, but here it is amylase. Name an organism in which extracellular digestion takes place, that is human beings, that is human beings. Now short answer type question we are studying. What is peristalsis movement? What is peristaltic movement? So A15, okay, on page number A15 we have to see the answers. Like, food is pushed downward by the contraction of the wall. It means food is just downward, goes to downward by the contraction of the our alimentary canal or wall. This is wall relaxes the next part of the oesophagus contract. Oesophagus means food pipe. Okay, so when one part is relaxed, next part is the contracts. So this relaxation and contraction is going on, and this creates a wave-like movement, and that is known as peristalsis. And due to this peristalsis movement, our food is easy to enter into the stomach, okay, and push downward. Okay, now next is, what is bile, how does it help in digestion. Bile is just secreted a juice, okay, from the liver, and by which this okay, we have to see here, this is short too. Liver secretes a juices which get stored in a, okay, liver generally secretes some juices, but initially they are just stored in a gallbladder, and after that gallbladder it secretes a juice into for the digestion, and bile helps to digest fats. Okay, emulsified fats are just it can be digested by the, it may bile helps to just digest the fats also. And now why is digestion of food is essential? It means why in our stomach there is a digestion of food is essential. So look, because to break down of the various complex nutrients, sometimes we are taking the food in the form of complex nutrients, and without the breakdown of this complex nutrient, we are not getting the proper energy. So present in the ingested food into the simpler and soluble soluble substance. It means when these complex nutrients are breakdown, then energy will come out. It means simpler and soluble substance only are just making the recharging of energy in our body. Without this complex nutrients are cannot able to without change, it means cannot able to give the nutrients properly or nutrition without changing into the simpler or soluble substance. What do you understand by the term egestion and ingestion? Egestion and ingestion. Okay, so with this answer we are also okay. So egestion, okay, egestion and ingestion on page number 30. Okay. So ingestion, the taking in of the food inside the body is called ingestion. It means just we have to take food inside to the body is known as ingestion. In human beings, ingestion takes place through the mouth. It means we are just starting this ingestion with the help of mouth. And next is egestion. Egestion means to expel out the undigested food. It means removal of undigested food and solid waste material from the body is called egestion. It means removal of undigested food and solid waste material from the body. Okay, so this is known as egestion. So both are the process for in our digestive system, human digestive system. What are villi and where are they located? So what are villi and where are they located? So look, the inner wall of a small intestine has a million of finger-like projections called villi. Okay, and many some smaller one also, that is also known as microvilli. So singular is villus. So and these villi increase the surface area so that maximum absorption of digested food. So due to this villi, the maximum surface area can be increased, and due to that the digested food takes place, maximum absorption also possible place. So they are located in the small intestine. You know about that. Here it is a small intestine. You can see this is the small intestine. This is the coil tube like structure is known as small intestine. And this is also the length in 6.5 meter. Okay. Total is a 9 meter long our alimentary canal. Out of that 6.5 is a small intestine. This small intestine contains many small finger like projection is known as villi. And these are the generally look in the diagram. This is the diagram. This is the small intestine and many villi and microvilli. These circular folds are present in our small intestine. So these are generally for using to absorption the many nutrients, and it is the increase the absorption area for increase the absorption area. Okay. What is alimentary canal? What is alimentary canal? So look, this is at the summary at the last downside. The part of digestive system from oesophagus to anus. It means from initial part to at the last part. It means where we have to expel out the food and we have to make. It means egestion is going off here and ingestion is going here. It means ingestion started here. Okay. So oesophagus to anus are the two oesophagus to anus, that is 9 meter long, that is the alimentary canal, and these are the part of digestive system. Everywhere there is a physical and chemical digestion, absorption of nutrients. It means food, solid food, sometimes the absorption of water also, okay, to make a solid unwanted food. Okay, so this is also going on this alimentary canal. Now the long answer type questions. Why should we brush after eating sugar products? It means after eating sugar products, sugar may be in the form of carbohydrates or in the form of food or anything, but why we should brushing after this? It means after taking the food or sugar product. So after each meal, gradually teeth become yellowish due to accumulation of some sticky film containing food particles mixed with saliva. It means after every food, there is a our teeth is become yellowish only due to the accumulation of some sticky film, and sticky film also produce on the teeth. Okay, and this is called plaque. Plaque is a yellow layer formed on our teeth. The sugary food matter present in plaque is converted into acid. So this sugary food is converted into acid by some bacteria generally present in the mouth and do not harm us. And it means the some bacteria which is present in our mouth and generally they are not harming to us. Okay, not this the part. And the acid so formed damage the enamel, causing tooth decay and leads to formation of cavity. So this acid continuously decomposition and degradation of this enamel, which is the hardest part of our body and upper covering part of this our one particular tooth. Okay, you see the enamel, dentine and pulp, and then arteries or veins are connected here. And due to that the acid is formed, then when acid is formed then plaque is formed. This is the showing the plaque, and when this is goes to at the root of this, then continuously our teeth are just become a very weak and formation of cavity which causes a severe pain. Okay, it is a very sensitive for hot and cold foods, okay, and drinks. So that's why we have to and a formation of cavity also, okay, formation of cavity also which causes severe pain. So this cavity is produced only due to this plaque. So to prevent this, we have to make brushing after every and each meal in the daytime, or maybe in the night time or in the morning. Okay, so after brushing we have to neutralize the acid formed in our mouth. What are the difference between intracellular digestion and extracellular digestion? What are the difference between intracellular and extracellular? So see here, the process of digestion takes place within the cell. This type of digestion is called intracellular digestion. It means process of which is take within the cell, this type of digestion is called intracellular. It means which is in the cell, it means within the cell, is known as intracellular. And example is amoeba. And while the process of digestion takes place outside the cell, it means outside the cell is known as extracellular digestion, that is in the human beings. Okay. Draw a label diagram of tongue showing test words for bitter, sweet, salty and sour taste. Okay. On here we have to see. So this is the showing that this is here the bitter, this is the sour taste, this is the salty nature taste, and this is the sweet taste. This is the answer for our long third. Now they define the following terms: ingestion and digestion, ingestion, digestion and egestion, ingestion, digestion and egestion. So these three are the definitions we already discussed. Now for ingestion, the taking in of the food inside the body, it means take inside the food, is known as ingestion. It can be happen in our human beings through the mouth. Digestion, the breakdown of the various complex nutrients present in the ingested food into simpler. It means the complex food is converted into the simpler soluble substance, is known as digestion, is known as digestion. And egestion, it means expelled out the unwanted and undigested food. So and where the nutrition already taken, so removal of undigested food and solid waste material from the body is called egestion. So it is a last one from the anus. We have to remove or rectum, remove the undigested food and solid waste material from the body, which is there is a unwanted things for our body. So I hope you understood this every question answer, and you will get a good mark in your PT first. So thank you.